Hello students, so the topic that we are doing right now is question tag. Now a very simple topic, something that is asked almost in all exams and something that is generally gone, like you know, generally goes wrong because kids feel ke ye to mujhe aata hai, ye to bahut easy hai, isme sochna kya hai, fatafat likh do and the answer goes wrong. Okay, so in this topic, though very easy, we'll be paying extra attention to ensure that our 100% marks are scored well, right? So, question tag. Now, how the question will be asked in this? In this, a sentence is given to you and you will be told, in the bracket, you will be instructed that you have to add a question tag to this, all right? So, say for example, the sentence is, India is great, which undoubtedly it is. So, if the sentence is, India is great, all right? So, in our answer, what we do is we first copy the whole sentence once again. India is great. We add a comma and we write two words and put a question mark. So technically speaking, this part is our answer. Comma, two words and question mark. All right. So in this topic question tag, we have a total of five types of sentences that can be asked. Learn each and every type, remember it, and do not attempt this topic in a hurry. Fatafat. Aram se, life is too long. We have a lot of time. No hurry in doing anything which will get us to worry later on. So, question tag. There are five types of sentences that can be asked in this topic. Now, all of you, forget this part of the board. Just keep looking where I'm telling you to look. Alright? Types. There are these five types of sentences that can be asked. The very first type is when the helping word is given to you. What is given to you? Helping word is given to you. Now, again, if you may have seen the tenses wala topic, we had discussed helping word. What is a helping word? Roughly, in a layman language, we have coined this definition as a word of which you can make the exact opposite either by adding not to it or removing not from it. What is a helping word? Helping word matlab kya? A word of which you can make the exact opposite either by adding not or by removing not. For example, say the word is. Okay. Is ka opposite kya aega? Isn't or is not. So, isn't mein apan ne kya kiya? Is ke baad we have added not. Wasn't ka opposite will be was. What have we done? We have removed not. So, what do we have in helping word? A helping word is a word of which you can make the exact opposite either by adding not or by removing not. So the very first type is when the helping word is given to you in the sentence. What will you do? You will see the helping word and if it does not have not, you will add not. If it has not, you will remove not. So basically in the first type, if the helping word is given to you, you will either add not to it or you will remove not from it. Okay. Now what we'll do is as we are doing these types, we'll also see the sentences. So I put the exercise alongside so that we are able to correlate the theory with the practical and see how we are able to use our knowledge in getting the answer. All right. I'll just get rid of this because we don't need it now. So basically, what are we expected to do? We are expected to put a comma, two words and a question mark. Okay. Before I proceed, remember, you have to copy the whole sentence once again. Like for example, if the question is people are good at heart, you have to write in the answer, people are good at heart, comma, aren't they, or whatever the answer is, right? So, the first sentence is, people are good at heart. Now, people are good at heart mein, are is the helping word, are ka opposite will be aren't. So, I will write, people are good at heart, comma, aren't they? Kya kiya apan ne? We have removed not from this, alright? See the second sentence. The show wasn't engaging for the audience. Wasn't is the word that we are on the lookout for. Wasn't ka, what we'll do is, wasn't ka opposite, was, not nikal diya. Alright. So, was aa gaya. The show ke liye, which is the suitable pronoun? It is it. So, was it? Question mark. Alright. I hope you have understood the first type. It's very simple. It's just that you have to be a little extra careful so that you don't get carried away. Ki chalo ji, easy hai, zyada dhyan nahi dena hai bas. The second one is when the question is an imperative sentence. इट इज एन इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस. व्हाट इज एन इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस? 3 सेकेंड्स. चलो सोचो. इंपेरेटिव, एन इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस इज अ सेंटेंस विच इज ईदर अ कमांड और एन ऑर्डर और अ रिक्वेस्ट. व्हाट इज एन इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस? एन इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस इज अ सेंटेंस विच इज अ कमांड, ऑर्डर और रिक्वेस्ट. So whenever you have the sentence which is imperative, meaning command, order or request, the answer to this will always be will you. What will the answer be? Will you. What will the answer be? Will you. Whenever you have an imperative sentence that is a command, order or request, the answer to this will always be will you. So comma, will you, question mark. In this type, you don't have to see whether it is positive or negative. If it is a command or an order or a request, you put will you with closed eyes. Not literally though. So attack the enemy. Attack the enemy is a command. So what you do? Put a comma and will you. Attack the enemy, comma, will you, question mark. Please help the poor, comma, will you, question mark. Alright, whenever you have a command, order or request, the answer to this will always be will you. Alright, I hope this is understood and this is becoming easier also. Why? You're learning something and directly applying it somewhere. Alright, so coming to the third type, that is suggestive sentence. What is a suggestive sentence? A suggestive sentence is a sentence which begins with let's or let us when you are suggesting something to someone. Now see, what is the difference between suggestion and advice? Now see, obviously, that will not be asked in this topic. Why we are understanding this is because generally people feel ke dono same hi hota hai. Almost same hota hai. There's a very slight difference. A suggestion includes you also. You are also a part of the suggestion. Like say, for example, let's eat. So let's eat mein you are also going to eat. Let's participate in a competition. So you are also going to be a part of that competition. And an advice can be you should rest, you should eat this, you should reduce your weight, you should not study. Whatever your advice is. Alright. So third type is when the question is a suggestive sentence. Suggestive means what? A sentence beginning with let's or let us. So whenever the sentence begins with let's or let us, the answer to this will always be shall we. What will the answer be? Shall we. What will the answer be? Shall we. Quick recap. First type is when the helping word is given to you. What is the helping word? A word of which you can make the exact opposite either by adding not or by removing not. So kya karne ka hai isme? Ya to not lagane ka hai, to not nikalne ka hai. Second type is when the question is an imperative sentence that is a command or a request. The answer will always be will you. The answer will always be will you. Third type is when the question is a suggestive sentence beginning with let's or let us. The answer will always be shall we. I hope it is very clear until now. We'll try applying the third one to some sentences. Let us complete the assignment. Don't read the sentence. Don't try to understand the meaning of it. Nothing. Let us dikha. Comma, shall we? Question mark. Let's give it our best shot. Forget whatever. Let's, Amira. Let's, comma, shall we? Question mark. I hope it is clear and it's becoming easier for you to understand. The fourth one is when the helping word given is any of these. See, there are these strange kind of helping words also. Like is ka, isn't, wasn't ka, was. Similarly, these are also helping words, but these are strange. So you can call them to be an exception. Okay, these are exceptions. Alright. So for these exceptions, there are certain words that you'll have to memorize. Okay, there is no principle of adding, not removing, not nothing. So if the helping word given to you is ain't, if the helping word is ain't, your answer will be an. See, just like is ka, you write isn't. Similarly, ain't ka you'll write am. Ain't ka you'll write am. Am ka you'll write aren't. Am ka answer is aren't. See, ain't ka answer is am. Am ka answer is aren't. Aren't ka answer is are. And are ka answer is aren't. If ain't is the helping word given to you in the question, see, just like is diya hai, apan kaise comma isn't ya was it aren't likhte. Similarly, if ain't is given to you, you will write am. If am is given to you, you will write aren't. If aren't is given, you will write are. And are is given, you will write aren't. Alright, a very, very simple way. You just have to memorize this. Aunt ka am, am ka aunt, aunt ka are ka aunt. Alright? Let's see. I ain't feeling lonely. Ain't, am. Remember the arrow marks. Huh? They don't interchange. They go in one direction only most of the times. So see, isme aur isme difference kya hai? Is ka answer is isn't. But isn't ka answer is also is in the first type. In this, ain't ka am hai, but am ka ain't nahi hai. Okay, so there is a slight difference there. I ain't feeling lonely. Ain't ka am. So I ain't feeling lonely. Am I? Question mark. I ain't feeling lonely. Am I? Alright. If the question is, I am ready to leave for work. Am. Am diya hai toh aren't. Am ka aren't. So I am ready to leave for work. Aren't I? Alright. The next one. Aren't ka are. People aren't aware of the new notice. Aren't ka are. So, people aren't aware of the new notice, comma, are ka, sorry, aren't ka are. Are they? The next one. My shoes are partly torn. Are ka aren't. Aren't they? Are you getting it? So, what you do is, if the helping word given to you is ain't, the answer will be am, am ka aren't ka are. Quick recap. The first type is when the helping word is given to you. What is the helping word? A word or phrase. You can make the exact opposite either by adding not or by removing not. So what you do? You either add not or you will remove not. Second type is when the question is an imperative sentence. Imperative means command, order, request. When it is a command, order, request, the answer will always be will you. Third type is suggestive. A suggestive sentence begins with let's or let us. The answer to this will always be shall we. Fourth type is these helping words. Ain't diya hai toh am, am diya hai toh aren't diya hai toh are diya hai toh aren't. I hope it is crystal clear until now. Now, the sentence in the fifth type, that is do form. Take 3 seconds, just think. When will the sentence come in the fifth type? When does the sentence come in the fifth type? Just like we is, was, the helping word, I got similar. Or for any other reason, when does the sentence land in the fifth type? Take 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. When will it come in the fifth type? See, a very, very basic way of judging. When will it come in the fifth type? When it will not come in the first 4 types, it will come in the fifth type. If the sentence does not come in the first 4 types, it comes in the fifth type. Common sense, basic, junior KG, everyone knows this. The whole world should know this. If you did not, you should actually be proud of yourself. So, fifth type is do form. See, on a serious note, when does a sentence land in the fifth type? If the sentence does not have a helping word given. Helping word nahi diya hai. Is, was, could, would, should, are, were, none of these are given to you. Alright? Imperative, it is not a command, not an order, not a request. Wo bhi nahi hai. Suggestive, it does not begin with let's or let us. It does not have ain't, am, aren't, are. Agar ye char type mein se nahi hai, to fifth type mein aayega, that is do form. Ab ye char type mein se nahi hai, to hoega kaisa? So see, let's see. I complete assignments fast. So let's see. Does it come in the first type? I complete assignment fast. Is, was, could, would, should, the I? No. We just write down all the types. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Alright. So, I complete assignments fast. Does it have a helping word? Is, was, could, would, should? Nahi hai. So type 1 nahi hai. Imperative. Is it a command, order, or request? No, it is not. Is it a suggestion? Does it begin with let's or let us? No, it begins with I. So it is not the third type as well. Is ain't given in this? No. Am? No. Aren't? No. Are? No. So if none of these 4 types are given, it will land in the fifth type, that is do form. Now, in the do form, listen very carefully. A little more focus is required in this type. In the fifth type, you have 3 tenses. Present tense, past tense, and future tense. Alright? Now, in the fifth type, you have to see whether the sentence belongs to the present tense, past tense or future tense. In the fifth type, if the question belongs to the future tense, fifth type, future tense, the answer will always be won't. The answer will always be won't. Pakka, hamesha won't hi rahega. If the sentence is in the past tense, it will always be didn't. It will always be didn't. Hamesha didn't hi aayega. Future tense always won't, past tense always didn't. Present tense mein ye topic mein bhi locha hai. Tenses mein locha tha, if you remember, ye topic mein bhi locha hai. Why? Because there are two options in this. See, future tense is very good, only one option won't. Past is also very good, only one option didn't. Present tense has locha in it. Why? Two options again. So, wapas thoda extra application of brains, which we generally avoid doing, to abhi isme thoda karte hai. Present tense mein, there are two words. See, present tense mein, there is an option of using doesn't also, there is an option of using don't also. Present tense mein, doesn't kabhi aega, don't kabhi aega, is what you need to know. Simple. इसमें इतना भी बड़ा लोचा नहीं है कि कुछ समझ में ही नहीं आएगा. प्रेजेंट टेंस में यू हैव टू रिमेंबर डजंट कभी आएगा एंड डोंट कभी आएगा. प्रेजेंट टेंस में इफ यू हैव ही शी और इट गिवन इन द सेंटेंस, कौन सा ही शी और इट, अगर टेंसेस का यू ऑल हैव सीन द वीडियो, सो ही शिट ही शी इट. सो इफ ही शी और इट इज गिवन इन द सेंटेंस, द आंसर विल बी डजंट. In the do form, present tense, if he or she or it is given in the sentence, the answer will always be does it. And he, she, it nahi diya hai, then the answer will be don't. Present tense, do form. He, she, it given to does it. He, she, it nahi diya hai to don't. He doesn't, she doesn't, it doesn't. I don't, you don't, we don't, they don't. I hope this particular part was clear to you. If not, pause the video. Listen to this once over. Alright? So, a quick recap of this question tag. We have to do the sentences of do form. So, he runs very fast. Runs very fast. Is there a helping word in this? Is, was, could, would, should? No. Imperative, command, order, request? Nahi hai. Suggestive, does it begin with let's or letters? Nahi. Ain't, am, aren't, are, diya hai, nahi diya hai. So we have it in the fifth type, that is do form. In the fifth type, you have to check whether it is present tense, past tense or future tense. He runs very fast. Runs. Runs is in which tense? Take 3 seconds, think. 2, 1. Okay. It is in the present tense. Very good if you have understood this, because this generally does not really strike to most people, though it is very obvious. He runs very fast. Present tense, okay? Chalo, present tense, so we got it. Now, in the present tense, he, she or it is given? Yes, he is given. He. So, in the present tense, if it is he, the answer will be doesn't. If in the present tense, it is he, the answer is doesn't. So, he runs very fast, comma, doesn't he, question mark. Clear? He runs very fast, doesn't he? Alright? Otherwise, the answer would have been don't. If it was, they run very fast. Okay, it is. They run very fast. So, run again, present tense. They is given. He, she, it is not given, so don't. Right? So, they run very fast, comma. Don't they? Question mark. Clear? I hope you're able to read whatever is being written. All right? The next one is past tense. In the past tense, you write didn't. Ram finished his homework. Finished. This word indicates past tense. Past tense. So, apne ko kya likhne ka hai? We will be writing the word didn't. So, Ram finished his homework, comma, didn't he? Question mark. Didn't he? Alright. Future tense, won't. I will reach home today. Will reach. Future tense, answer will always be won't. So, I will reach home today, comma, won't I? Question mark. Won't, because it is in the future tense. We'll quickly recap the entire topic once again. There are 5 types of sentence that can be asked in question type. The first type is when the helping word is given to you. What is the helping word? Is, was, could, would, should, a word of which. You can make the exact opposite either by adding not or by removing not. Second type is when the question is an imperative sentence. Imperative means command, order, request. The answer to this will always be will you. Third type is suggestive. When the question begins with let's or let us, the answer will always be shall we. Fourth is when the helping word given to you is ain't. Ain't ka am. Am ka aren't. Aren't ka are. Are ka aren't. And if it doesn't come in the first four types, it comes in the fifth type. Fifth type, do form. Do form, you have to check whether it is present tense, past tense or future tense. Future tense, the answer will always be won't. Past tense, the answer will always be did. Present tense has locha. Why? There are two types. He, she, it, the I, to doesn't. He, she, it, nahi, the I, to don't. So that's it for question tag. I hope you have understood this topic well. At the end of this lecture, after you are done doing these also, there is a worksheet that I have sent across to you. Do practice it and you will feel good about yourself because this topic is really very easy. I hope you understood it well. And until next time, I'll see you. This is Ronak sir saying goodbye. God bless you.